I've been playing on the public test servers for the last few days, and honestly, there are a few things that do concern me about the current state about the SWTOR PTS, especially when looking at how close we are at the current release of 7.0 Legacy of the Sith. So in this video, I will talk about 5 of the biggest concerns that I have as a longtime player and why it should maybe also concern you as well. Let's talk about gearing first. I made a different video last week, which I decided against uploading onto my YouTube channel. But allow me to show you a few clips of what I recorded for this video, because it's very much a big concern of mine. First, let me tell you how you are to obtain gear with those upcoming changes. You get up to 318 item rated gear by just doing the story content. And everything after it will be through item rewards, which you will need to upgrade at these vendors. And this is where it gets tricky. You get operation, flashpoints and conquest gear for PvE content. And then PvP gear for PvP. And all these different types of gear will also have different types of currencies, which you will need to grind before you can upgrade those specific gear pieces. And then you also have different type of item tier ratings, which are all depending on the type of gear you get. You are able to get 324 for veteran flashpoints, 326 for mass mode flashpoints, conquest, war zones and veteran legacy operations, 328 maximum for story legacy operations, 330 for master legacy operations, and eventually 334 for veteran current operations. Now, try to memorize what I all just said without having to note it down. Yeah, it's a little bit much, isn't it? So to get to the point, it's way too difficult and complicated for the majority of us players. And that will bring me to the second concern, the gear grind. Again, I'm gonna show you another clip of this video. Now let's take a look at, for example, PvP. With PvP, you only get a box that has a PvP item in it, which is determined by the slot with the lowest item rating of your equipment. This is where you finish the weekly. Sounds nice, right? So you get the item drop and you want to upgrade it. So you go to the vendor and you see that, for example, this specific item will cost you 25 Medals of Commendations, 35 Tarisian and 30 Aquatic together with some credits. And the names that I just said are all different type of tokens on different types of content. So, for example, Tarisian is PvP tokens, while Aquatic you get mostly for doing PvE dailies and heroics. And now you think, well, I only do PvP in the game. How long will this take me? You expect to be able to grind most of it through PvP, but nope, that's not true. You only get 2 Aquatic out of the 30 needed by completing the PvP weekly on your character. At least you do get enough Tarisian tokens. So let's look at the daily. Maybe we'll give the daily something. The daily will only give you 2 medals out of the 25 needed. And 0 aquatic of those tokens. So imagine you just want to upgrade one piece from 320 to 322. This will take you over 13 dailies and 15 weeklies just to complete one small item upgrade by just doing war zones. And this is only from 320 to 322. One item. Just imagine how long it will take you by just getting there to PvP. But now you're saying, hey Avi, I don't just do PvP. I also like PvE flashpoints, or I don't PvP at all. So let's take a look at PvE flashpoints. To upgrade this chest piece, you need 35 Medals of Commendations, 135 Durisian Isotope Stabilizers, 25 aquatic, and that is only to get the item piece from 320 to 322. The weekly group finder gives you 2 medal of accommodations and nothing else that you will need for this upgrade. And the same goes for the master flashpoints to the group finder. It however gives 4 instead of 2. This while the weekly missions only give a piece of gear and nothing else. But how do you get the aquatic and Durisian tokens if it doesn't drop from this loot? Aquatic drops from daily and heroic areas, and this is so far also the only efficient way of getting it. This while Durisian drops from bosses in Mastermind flashpoints, as I've yet to see a drop from any veteran. Luckily, you can deconstruct the gear that you got in the veteran flashpoints, but doesn't give much when you look at how much you have needed. So deconstructing this piece will only give you 5. And remember how much we need again for this original piece, 135. And now we only talked about group content, let's talk about conquest. Yeah, there isn't really much which will give you a basic piece of gear, so good luck getting gear if you're just doing conquest. you are slowly being pushed into doing group content. So yeah, that's just about the gear grind and about those tokens. Sounds very grindy, doesn't it? And then we also have the character designer. At first, I don't think there's much wrong with the character designer, but there are a few things that they can do really better. For example, longtime players will know in the origin what the different characters mean. With, for example, operative and scoundrel, those are the mirror classes. But will first time or long time returning players know the difference? I think they should do something where it's very easy to see for new players that those two different classes are connected to each other and that they are almost the same. And then, when you also go to your appearance, you don't see what your choices were at the previous screen. It's a small minor thing when it comes to design, but in the current design, you get constantly reminded of what you chose before. I think they should also implement that. And they should make the zoom button also zoom in even more. That's just a minor thing. Maybe they will change that, maybe not. But yes, that's the UI of only the character creation. Let's talk about the UI in the game itself. I like how they are changing many parts of the UI in the game, but there are a few things that just don't really look finished. For example, look at the inventory. It is very bright and it doesn't show the whip icon, which you'll have in your other screens when it's very much whip. So it concerns me that it is very bright and compared to what we have right now in the game, it just doesn't look the same of the order UI in the game. For example, with your abilities bar. And then lastly, let's talk about a few bugs that there are still in the game. So it's not much of a concern, but this is still a thing that you would think they would try at least fix for the 10-year anniversary celebration. That, like, just look at this. Like, this guy lost his hat in the cutscene. And this is Rise of the Herd Cartel. This expansion is so old already, and there are still those major bugs in there. So yeah, it's kind of a concern that they are still in there. I know that they're not a big focus right now, because they're working on 7.0 Legacy of the Civ. But come on guys, go fix your old bugs. So yeah, those are my main concerns that I have currently about the public test server from Star Wars The Old Republic. And I know it's a public test server, which means things are likely going to be changed. But still, the concerns are there. If they won't get changed, then I don't know. So yeah, please let me know what you think of this video. What you think of those things on the current public test server. And yeah, thank you all so much for watching. If you don't know me, I'm Avi. I'm a big Star Wars The Old Republic fan. And I make videos about it as well. So go subscribe to the channel if you have not already. Smash the like button. And I will see you all in the next video.